Hello folks and welcome to episode 7 of our Let's Play Erannorth Reborn series, and today we will be playing with the character I have prepared here, an Undying Blood Mage. This will be our attributes, this is our affinities, and we will be playing in the adventure mode to show you some changes here. We are in the latest build, 0260, which is available in both the development and the default branch, and features all the sound effects in the game along with many improvements. So if you haven't played the adventure mode before, you are here in front of a tactical map and you can choose locations and explore them. You can only explore the locations of the settlement you are currently in. So currently I'm in Grisbook. I can click here to explore it. I can also click here to explore it. This is the settlement itself. I can enter any time between my adventures and spend my hard-earned coin. I can also toggle between the map and my character using this button here. And we can also preview what the other areas have, what rewards they might offer, but we can't explore them till we actually go there. Okay, so if I want to explore these areas in Lanmerich, I have to be in Lanmerich, otherwise I can't. You can travel to any adjacent location by using these travel buttons here. Travel is instant, it will only advance the world clock and also cost you rations or gold, depending if it's by land or by sea. Green means that this is an easy area, white it's normal difficulty, and red you will most likely die. Imagine that these enemy levels correspond to what the stage would have been if you were playing a normal Iron Man. So if you meet level 5 enemies, these are the level 5 enemies you meet in stage 5, for example, of a mode. Pretty tough. Okay, so make sure you gain some levels before you tackle of higher level areas. You can keep exploring any non-unique area and farm the various rewards. For example, these are the rewards we can get in the Southeast Lake. These are the rewards we can get in the North Lake. And it's important to keep a varied deck and also acquire cards from other disciplines, because there is something called leyline affinity and leyline aversion. Leyline affinity will increase the damage and the power of the summons of the affected elements, whereas the leyline aversion will penalize them significantly, make them almost unplayable. So Grisbook Lake has a leyline affinity of light, earth, astral, and leyline aversion of dark and air, meaning that using dark and air spells in these two areas here is a very bad idea. Still, that's what most of our spells are, so let's see how we'll deal with this. Let's start here, explore. I will need right away to adjust my deck. I'll go here, my deck, removal cards from deck, using this new functionality we have to quickly empty my deck, and now add water cards, lots of water cards, something to synergize damage like the bloodletting, and I won't be using the bloodlust because I need to have blood search to expand. But I will be using the blood sacrifice because it will give us the vigor mortis. Despite weak, they can still offer us a synergy of drain, and that's pretty good. to have. This is our deck, as less dark oriented as possible. And we can use the hourglass button to explore, camp or prepare. Prepare option has changed, and you get to choose between these cards were picked from a pool of 8 cards. Some of them are fixed and some of them are random chosen. I will take procure, blood and continue. Let's use wet. Now that he's wet, he can get the intense damage of the conditional statement. We'll use the blue orb, which, as you can see, dealt -3 damage. Okay, that's significantly penalized. And use the procure blood. But be careful when you use procure blood. Your bleeding gets +2. Your character will start bleeding. Okay, that's how you create this preserved blood. So we have a bleeding 2. End my turn. Enemies are attacking. You can adjust the speed these cards fly by going to your settings. So now our bleeding is 3 because procure blood is echoing. Now another thing that you might wonder is when this echo actions trigger. Okay, so the new build includes a verbose mode you can activate by pressing the plus on your numerical keypad. So it will read here verbose mode on, and right now we won't see any difference, so let's play till the time to think comes. We lost life. What blood offering does is we lose as much hit points as it says, and we gain blood surge, which is half this value rounded up. The only value in Erannorth I can recall that it's actually rounded up. Okay, so we lost 3 hit points, we gained 2 blood surge, and we can now synergize drain to get some hit points back, and also use the blood sacrifice, which will give us the vigor mortis. I can play, inflict the drain. See how weak he is? That's because of the dark aversion. He got a +-3 power and a +-6 health. Shouldn't really say +-3. I will fix that. Let's continue and our turn. And now you will see what the verbose mode does. Let's go and get a look. End of turn effects trigger. We got the bleeding. We lost 3 hit points. Echo actions trigger. Procure blood, targeted Riza. We got +2 bleeding. This after it triggers, it becomes bleeding 2. So 2 and 2 equals the 4 we have now. We craft 1 preserved blood, we lose 4 action points. We received this action. So this is where the echo action triggers, the moment you click and your turn. After that, the aura effects trigger, if any, and the enemy main phase starts. Enemy turn, Murkith attacks, reinforcements phase, bonus and penalty effects debuff. And our turn comes. Draw phase, main phase, we can now start playing. Okay, this is the verbose mode. You can leave it on, you can close it by the same plus key in your numerical key, but I will leave it on for a bit. Let's use preserved mode. Summon another vigor mortis. Keep in mind that in order to successfully use this card, I need to expend blood shards. So I need to have blood shards equal to that amount here. Otherwise, the action will fizzle. So using this Vigor Mortis, I can just right click him. Expends, you lose 2 blood shards. And it summoned, weakened. Still, we get this drained synergy, which we can use to drain life from the Merkith. Okay. Let's prepare for the challenges ahead. We'll get the dark fire. Continue.
This is terrible.
So this is terrible. We are ambushed. Ambushes now is a bit different. Enemies with the flank tactic will get flanking counters and trigger them right away. So this is our vulnerability for coming from these two flank counters. And after we kill this enemy and end our turn, this value will reevaluate. So let's get rid of here first. We can use our dark fire, which deals only 2 damage. The darker version changed to -2. You can click this button while in combat and you will see the active node rules. Leyline rules change at every node, so it's different here, here, here. The element stays the same, but this value -2 and 1 fluctuates, okay? Finish here. Let's use some drain. We can summon the Vigor Mortis. Summon some more hit points. And end our turn. Use plus on the Illusion Weaver. Our hit points are full, so we don't need to recover any. If the target has +1 wet counter, that's this counter here, wet, created by this echo action, then it will get intense 4, but it will also adjust their vulnerable counters to +2. So let's see. Damage he gets, nothing, avoids all damage because he has concealment. So let's try to blink him with our Rigor Mortis. Continue. Let's first do an exploration and then a preparation. We don't have enough action points. The vampire event, we don't care with this character in particular. We are in a small thorp. Because town nodes, when you are in an adventure mode, change to this event here, because you can access towns in between your adventures. I will just leave. Now I can synergize the Drain 4 into my multicasted Inconspicuous Disguises. Both got 4 damage. I can also make him vulnerable and finish him off with my Vigor Mortis. So as you can see, having this additional verbose information will make it easier to understand exactly what happened when. I will turn it off for now. Use the Bloodstone Orb. We also got this blood offering, that's why we lost it once. We'll get them back. Upon drawing this card, we get to cast 2 weights on the Dire Panther. So now we can just splash him for intense damage. Using this here has absolutely no effect. This enemy doesn't have a wet counter, this enemy doesn't have a vulnerable counter, so it will be a wasted splash. Let's use that stone orb. And now actually splash can be beneficial because it will get this drain synergy. So I can just use it. Also craft a vigor mortis and finish the encounter. Prepare for the challenges ahead. I will get the blood loss, which deals plagionic damage, and at blood tribute crafts a vigor mortis. Of course you need to pay the expend cost of the vigor mortis, so keep an eye on your blood surge. You need to have 3 to cast it and 2 to summon the vigor mortis upon blood tribute. Continue. I won't be entering in the camp. And as you can see, that was the echo blood sacrifice on Riza. And we have 2 Vigor Mortis cards now. Let's learn the Ice Arrow. Play Bloodstone Orb. Multicast the Drain. Use 2 Blood Surge to summon the Vigor Mortis. Right click to trigger the drain synergy, plus the drain vigor mortis always has as an ability, and I will use this tranquil house. Play the blood lightning, synergize damage, summon another mortis, drain 6. And end my turn. Withdraw splash, let's use it. Let's also use Stone Orb. And right click activates Rigor Mortis ability, which is drain plus the synergy from our previous action. And let's explore. We got an encounter for us. I will use Tranquility. No, I don't have any action points. But I can use the Vigor Mortis ability. So if you notice, when each enemy acts, will now highlight. And it should be really obvious which enemy is acting, which enemy is attacking, and what happened for that from that attack. Let's play Blood Sacrifice. With this blood surge I will play the Vigor Mortis, synergize the additional drain he gives me, throw the Bloodstone Orb, synergize the drain to my Tranquility card, synergize my Focus and Meditate into my Inconspicuous Disguise card, and let's try to finish here off. Good, now we can use Splash to finish him off as well. And we are left with the Necromancer, who will summon an undead, probably. He doesn't.
Oh no!
He does. Ah, no, that was reinforcements. This is the oh no message. And let's try to bloodlust here. Okay. You You can't use Drain on the undead, Dark Damage also don't hurt them. So 3 to 7 damage is not enough to kill here. Drain won't have any effect, so these cards are pretty much useless. I will just discard this Vigor Mortis here and this Blood Sacrifice and end my turn. Let's use the Bloodstroke Orb. Attack. Attack. No one actually deals any damage. I will discard these cards and then count it vulnerable. 3 to 7 damage won't kill here. Drain won't affect here. Okay, now we can try the Blood Loves. And the Blood Tribute, we don't have expense to summon the Vigor Mortis. Preparation. I will take the preparation.
This is terrible.
We are ambushed. Let's use the
Blood Orb.
We got a level, Drain, create another Vigor Mortis, Drain, and let's continue. We lost life from the Blood Sacrifice. We can synergize Drain for Inconspicuous Disguise. We also have plenty of Blood Shards. Let's draw some cards. Use a Bloodletting. Damage and Drain together. The Drain. Put here in the front. Keep the heat. And our turn. Let's prepare for the final encounter of this particular area.
This is terrible.
We are ambushed, we lose 4 defense. Only those enemies with flank counter trigger the vulnerability. We suffer. Let's use a weight on him. Got the synergy damage. Let's use a weight on him. So splash the intense damage. Get rid of this one too. And this is it. We finished the first area. And we get to pick 2 cards. Perfect. Because I can pick both of them and return to the world map. Now the status here changed. We can change a bit from being the underdog to having a leyline affinity this time, because dark is boosted in the Mars. This is the rewards we can be getting. Plenty of cool stuff. And let's explore. This is the state we have been in. Before I adjust my deck to be more dark, I will start.
This is terrible.
We are ambushed. All of them have the flank ability. We are vulnerable 8. As you can see now, we are getting bonus damage. And let's see what will happen to these puny rigor mortises. Now we are talking. As you can see, their health and their power is boosted. Their ability is exactly the same as it was. Okay. We'll use this card. And we don't have enough blood shards. This means that our rigor mortis got upgraded. Okay. We are level 2. I will increase my resilience. It's very important for a blood mage. And I will go and do a quick empty my deck after making all these cards into skills. Making these cards into skills is not something I recommend you to do because it costs 5 tokens, okay? I just happen to have 823 and I have unlocked everything, so I find the adventure mode more enjoyable by giving myself more deck building options. So let's go for a dark deck this time and use all of our Blood Mage cards. But we also need 2 additional cards, which will be the empty mags. They deal bludgeoning damage and they are quite useful. Actually, I will also get 2 inconspicuous disguises. Perks, I will be getting we will be getting Tenacious and we will be getting Tough. So our character is pretty tough now and can withstand the damage she deals to herself. Okay, he attacked for 9, sneak attack. When an enemy is concealed, they deal double damage. And we had vulnerability, so there you have it. Let's drain him into oblivion. Prepare. Play the mind over body. It's a bad idea to explore when you have a vulnerability, because if you get into an encounter, your enemies will benefit from this vulnerability of yours. Let's put the wick in the front. We don't have blood shards. We have now 3. He needs 3, it's the upgraded version of himself. Move this one front. We can't use the dark fires. Liquid courage. We can't bring benefit. Let's mutate it into the empty mug. And now finish off the encounter. Find a dead adventurer, let's pick these cards. Now we'll leave this.
This is terrible.
We are ambushed. We are just concealed. We don't have a vulnerability. Okay, let's do a preparation. Do the blood offering. Play the bloodstone orb here, because this is the only guy we can actually drain from. So it's end our turn. So spell preparation is a reaction. If you don't use it, you will lose it. So let's use it. Let's play the blood up here. And now use the preparation. Won't do anything, I just want to increase my blood search so I can play the bloodlass, and also triggered the vigor mortis blood tribute, so both of them needed 6. They can damage the vampires. He has +2 dark resistance. That's an dark turn.
Oh no!
Reinforcements arrive. Let's try to attack here. Finish here off with the blood. And at this point, I will just let him attack. I will discard this. We have a trinket that gives mark and blood preparation leads or vigor mortis. What else we have in our deck? We have this elixir. Let's attack him. If I use this blood offering, I will kill myself. Let's get rid of these cards. Play them in monk. Play me in conspicuous disguise. And do a total deck makeover. Let's switch to our water. Okay, and now I hope that we will be able to find some living and drain them. So I will use this Blood Mage spellbook and also have these cards here. We'll keep the blood sacrifice, we'll keep the preparation, we'll also keep this and this. Okay, so we have some living, we have our hit points back to a good spot. We can use this. Drain both of them in the cast. And we're at 25. 28. Craft a bit from this. Drain this one to 33. Cards. 32. Okay. Prepare for the challenges ahead. Let's get. Now that we have plenty of hit points, we can spare some of your blood. It gives us bleeding. It will keep increasing the bleeding every round it's active. Till it finally goes away. Continue. Pick the pouch, pick the backpack. That's good to have. Continue. So our bleeding will now go away. We can just continue here. Let's loot the sleeping guard. With 5 blood shards, I can summon my first vigor mortis. And with 1 spell preparation, I can summon the second as well. Finish him off before he seals up and end our turn. Let's also use this. Summon the vigor mortis. We don't have enough blood sets. So always keep an eye on your blood sets. We have undead here, so let's add this bloodlust cards. We can damage them with drain. It will come to a drain. We will level up soon. Okay, let's shuffle our deck so we can have a possibility to draw the. We didn't need the blood lasses after all. Let's set a camp and prepare. I will get the bloodletting. Use the liquid cards. Transfer it with tranquility. Let's use the blue sacrifice on here. 3 and 3, we need more. Let's use the blood sacrifice here as well. Okay. But now we do it. Let's use the ritual to summon the second Vigor Mortis and finish things off. It's a camp, continue.
Level up.
We gained a level, that's always good. We can keep draining. We are now at full 51 hit points. Pretty good place to be. Let's finish the one with the most hit points. Discard one, discard one. Keep up the attack. Fighting living enemies, it's the best thing in the world for the blood mains, because they can drain them, they can find them in so many beautiful ways. But against the undead, your choices are more limited, and you have to be careful because your own blood offerings might kill you. That's it, we finished the second area, and now we get to pick two cards from these. I will pick the Exorcist robes, and we'll also pick the Light Shield. Turn to the world map, and now let's say that we wanted to actually travel to Lanmerich. I would go to the Thorpe, buy provisions for the trip, check what cards that might be here I might want. Let's pick this Elixir of Wisdom, for example, and now choose travel to Lanmerich. We are here, travel is instant, time advances in the game. We have now 3 rations, 164 farthings, and we can explore what these cards, these places have to offer, build a very nice collection of cards, and have the deck building options to deal with the various leyline affinities we will encounter here. So, once you are ready to finish things up, you can go to Demos Hasm and do the final gate, the endgame quest, which is for players level 19 to 20. In the meantime, have fun, enjoy the adventure mode, and see you next time.